students, welcome to the session 13. So today we would like to discuss about a gas turbine power plant only. And in the previous class, we are discussing about a gas turbine plant and types of a gas turbine power plant and what are the components of a gas turbine power plant, layout of a gas turbine power plant. Okay, so the main important components of a gas turbine power plant is, so the first thing is the compressor, next one is the combustor, there is the combustion chamber, and next we would like to connect to the combustion chamber to the turbine. Okay, so the working fluid in a gas turbine power plant is the air, high temperature and high pressure air, that is the working fluid here. And the fuel used in a gas turbine power plants are generally high octane fuels. So we know that natural gases generally we preferred because of high octane number. Okay. So, in the last class, we are discussing about a type classification of a gas turbine power plant. In a classification, we have mainly two types of classification based on the constant pressure and the constant volume are two types. In a constant pressure, the gas turbine power plants are mainly two types. So, what are the two types of a gas turbine power plants? So, the gas turbine power plants are mainly classified into two types. One is the open cycle gas turbine power plant, and second one is the closed cycle gas turbine power plant. Okay, so in your open cycle gas turbine turbine and in your open cycle gas turbine and the closed type gas turbine. So what is the difference between the open cycle gas turbine and closed cycle gas turbine? So the main difference of a open cycle gas turbine and the closed cycle gas turbine, okay, the rotation of a fluid. Okay, so the fluid medium, working fluid is the air. So the air is continuously moving atmosphere to the suction into the compressor, compressor to the combustion chamber to the turbine. But at final stage, the air is moves towards the atmosphere. So that type of process is known as the open cycle process. So in this plant, in this type of plant, the atmospheric air is charged into the combustor through a compressor. After that, what happened? The exhaust of the turbine also discharged to the atmosphere. So where we are taking the air, so we are taking the fresh air from the atmosphere. So this is here. So we are taking the fresh air from the atmosphere. So that fresh air is entered into the compressor. So in this compressor, that air is compressed at a maximum pressure. So at that point, it increases the temperature and pressure of a atmospheric air. Why? Because we need to do the compression process. So when the compression process is happened, automatically the air having a high temperature and high pressure conditions, so it leads to the better combustion process. So after the compressed air, so we need to send to the combustion chamber, combustor. Okay, so this is the combustion chamber. So here we are entering to the compressed air. So what happened for a combustion process, what we require? So for the combustion process, we require the fuel. So here we are injecting the fuel which is having a high octane number. Okay. So generally, most of the gas turbine power plants we are using natural gases. Okay. So the fuel is entered and the compressed air also entered. So here the combustion is takes place. Okay. Here the combustion is takes place. After the combustion, it releases to a high pressure, high temperature air. That high pressure and high temperature air, so that means here it releases heat energy. So that heat energy is converted into the kinetic energy. So with the kinetic energy, so here the turbine is placed here. So this type of turbines are known as the gas turbine power plant, because here we are using working fluid as a gas. In case of you are using a steam as a working fluid, so that turbine is known as a steam turbine. In case of if you are using working fluid as a water, so that turbine is known as the hydraulic turbine. So based on the working fluid, we can name it as the turbines. Steam turbines, hydraulic turbines and the gas turbine. So here we are using the working fluid as a gas at a high temperature and the high pressure. So that's the reason it is known as a gas turbine. So in this gas turbine, okay, what happened? So the high kinetic energy of a gas is strikes the turbine blades. So turbine blades are like this. So So when it is strikes with a high energy, high temperature and high pressure gas, automatically it starts the rotating. Okay, so it kinetic energy is converted into the mechanical energy. So here the kinetic energy is converted into the mechanical energy. So from that mechanical energy, the turbine is coupled with a alternator or generator. So here the mechanical energy is converted into the electrical energy. So these are the cycles. So initially we are taking the chemical energy. The chemical energy is converted into the heat energy. Heat energy to the kinetic energy. Kinetic energy to the mechanical energy. Mechanical energy is converted into the electrical energy. So what are the components we are using? Compressor, compression chamber, turbine, generator, and this is the shaft. So what do you mean by shaft? So shaft is a device which transfers the energy from one point to the another point. Okay, but the problem is in this entire cycle, so we are taking a continuous fresh air from the ambient and we are releases that exhaust gases into the again ambient conditions. Okay, so that's the reason. So this type of cycles are known as the open cycle. So we don't recirculate that combustion or exhaust air. That's the reason this is known as the open cycle gas turbine power plant. Okay, so next coming to the second one is the closed cycle gas turbine power plant. So in a closed cycle gas turbine power plant, so the gas is regenerated or recycled of a exhaust process. So we can consider some amount of air, so fixed amount of air, fixed mass of air. So that is continuously rotating in the cycle. So that type of process is known as a closed cycle. So see here, in this type of power plant, the mass of air is constant or another suitable gas used as the working medium. Okay, circulate through the cycle over and over again. So this is the thing. So we are taking the one gas and that gas we are circulating continuously without replacement of a fresh air. That process is known as the closed cycle. See the closed cycle diagram here. The components are more or less equal. So what are the components here? Compressor, heat exchanger, it is nothing but a combustion chamber, and the turbine. And this is also heat exchanger, that is a condenser. Okay. So, what is the purpose of a compressor? So, compressor, same principle. Here, compresses the air taken from the heat exchanger. And then it is passed through the, compressor air passed through the heat exchanger. That means we are here supply the heat. So, Q input, heat supplied. And heat rejected, Q out. Heat supplied and heat rejected. And these two processes are the isentropic process. So these two processes are the constant volume processes. Okay. And coming to the, I would like to improve the efficiency of gas turbine power plant. So what is the necessity to increase the gas turbine power plant efficiency? So simple thing. If you consider an open cycle gas turbine power plant, so the open cycle gas turbine power plant, we are using the components of compressor, turbine, okay, combustion chamber. So in this components, so most of the work is used for the compressor. So what compressor is the work requiring device. Compressor is a work requiring device. Turbine is a work producing device. So if you want the more amount of power generated through the gas turbine power plant, the energy derived by a gas turbine is most of the energy is used for the running of a compressor. Okay, so here we would like to improve the efficiency of a gas turbine power plants in a open cycle. So for that, they propose three methods of a three techniques are used to improve the gas turbine efficiency in a open cycle. So what are the three methods? So the first one is the regenerating, or it's also known as a regenerator, and the second one is intercooling technique, and the third one is a reheating process. So we are learning about three things or three methodologies we are using to improve the gas turbine efficiency. So what are the three methods? First one is the regenerating or regenerator. Second one is the intercooling process. And third one is the reheating process. So what What does it mean by regenerating? So, the regenerating means, so here we can utilize the energy. Okay, here we can utilize the energy of a exhaust gases. So, for example, if you are do the combustion process through the combustor, after that the combustion chamber process, that air is passed through the turbine. After the turbine process, what we are doing generally in open cycle, so the, we are removing the exhaust gases and we are directly send the exhaust gases to the ambient energy, ambient conditions. But in case of, we can utilize that exhaust gas temperature for heating the compressed air, it gives a better combustion process. Automatically it shows the better efficiency when compared to the normal open cycle gas turbine power plant. So the same thing here, the exhaust gases from the turbine carry a large quantity of heat with them since their temperature is far above the ambient temperature. So what we can do for that? So we need to utilize that energy at high temperature heat for regenerating the process. Okay, they can be used to heat the air coming from the compressor, thereby reducing the mass of fuel supplied in the combustion chamber. So that is very helpful to reduce the mass of fuel consumption. Okay, so simply see here. Okay, so in this regenerating process, we are using the heating the air, compressed air, by the using of a exhaust gases. So where we are taking the, after the turbine process, so we are using that heat energy. Okay, so what we are getting the heat exhaust gases, so that exhaust gases we can utilize for a heating of a compressed air. So in this diagram you can see the schematically. So here the first thing you can observe here, so the fresh air is taken from the atmosphere. This is the starting stage, it is represented as 1. So the air is taken from the ambient energy, and here by using a compressor, so that way we can do the compression process. So this is the stage 2. So the process 1 to 2 is the compression process. Okay, so the process 1 to 2 is the compression process. What we are doing in the latter? So in the latter stage, we are using a heat exchanger. So heat exchanger means transfer of temperature from one body to the another body. When the heat transfer takes place, generally the heat transfer takes place when the high temperature and the low temperature is available. So here the high temperature is available after the turbine process, and the low temperature means we are taking the compressed air here. So here the heat is transferred between one point to the another point, and here what happened? So automatically the energy is transferred from high level to the low level. Okay, so this is the general phenomena. So always energy is moving from high position to the low position, conservation of energy. Okay, so here it absorbs the temperature. Okay, so that means it raises the temperature. Okay, so the rising temperature after it reaches to stage 3. So 2 to 3 is the heat addition process. After that, it has a high temperature when compared to the compressed condition. And here we can do the combustion process by using a combustion chamber. So this is a combustion chamber, and after the combustion process, so state 3 to state 4. So these are the states, state 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So total we have a 6 states. So already do you know what is mean by state? So at a particular point of work is known as the state. Okay. So here, after the combustion process, the high temperature and the high pressure gases are sent into the turbine. So that causes to the, it is moving, high pressure and high temperature air is continuously flowing, so it has some kinetic energy. So that kinetic energy is moving the turbine blades. Okay, so this is the work done by a 4 to 5. So this is the 5th point. So here 4 to 5. So what happened here? Turbine process. So turbine also a isentropic process, reversible adiabatic process. Okay. After that, here the exhaust gases are sending to the atmosphere through the heat exchanger. Okay. So this process is known as a regenerating process. So what happened in a regenerating process? In a regenerating process, So we are using the heat energy of a exhaust gases. Okay, so we are using the exhaust gas temperature for increase the temperature of a compressed air. Okay, so due to this process, we are getting the higher efficiency due to the better combustion process. Okay, so this is about a regenerating process. So this is the one technique to improve the gas turbine power plant efficiency in a open cycle method. And similarly, we have two more methods are available. So that two methods are, the first one is the, second one is the intercooling technique, and the third one is the reheating technique. So later we would like to go about the intercooling technique. So what is mean by intercooling technique? So intercooler is connecting between the two turbines here, two compressors, high pressure compressor and the low pressure compressor. So in between these two, we are fixing a one intercooler. Why? Because the entire power generation in a gas turbine power plant, most of the power is utilizing for a compression process only. So see here, a compressor utilizes the major percentage of power developed by a gas turbine. So for that, what we can do? So for that, the work required by the compressor can be reduced by the compressing of air in a two stages. Okay, so that automatically reduces the effect of a power utilization. Incorporate an intercooler between these two. So we are using a two stage compressor. One is a high pressure compression and second one is a low pressure compression. Okay, so here in this case, see in this diagram here. So first, initially we would like to take the ambient air from the atmosphere. So similar, so this is a state one, thermodynamic state one, taking the air from the atmosphere, and that is entered into the compressor. So generally we are compressing in a low level. Okay, so that's why very less pressure, so that's why it is known as the low pressure compressor. So the pressure is increases after that compression process. So that is the state 2. Okay, so if here the based on the thermodynamic properties, temperature and pressure, so we can define the state. So this is the state 1 and state 2. After that, we are using the intercooler. So this intercooler uses to the increase the pressure once again. After that, so that intercooler process, after the intercooler process, we can send that same air compressed air into the high pressure compressor. Okay, so after the high pressure compressor, so here the state 3 and this is the state 4. Okay, so after the high pressure compressor, it gives a more temperature and more pressure when compared to the normal compressor. So if you, for example, if you utilize a single compressor, it gives some amount of pressure, for maybe 4 bar of pressure or 10 bar of pressure, but we are doing the compression process in a multi stages. One is a low pressure stage and second one is a high pressure stage. So after that, we can get a high pressure and high temperature gases. So that gases we can enter into the combustion chamber. So this is a combustion chamber. In this, we are doing the combustion process. Okay, and we are entering the fuel from the another direction. So this is the fuel. Okay, after the compression, after the combustion process, same cycle is repeats once again. So the combustion, it gives the high pressure and high temperature air. So that is flows on the turbine here. So this is the turbine here. In this turbine, what happened? So the high pressure and high temperature air is flows. So the steam or air is expanded here. The air is expanded. So due to the expansion process, so the turbine is rotates. And here we are utilizing the same thing alternator. After that, the air is entered into the atmosphere. So the thing is similar in all the cases is, so we are leaving the exhaust gases into the atmosphere always. We are leaving the exhaust gases in the atmosphere because it's an open cycle. Okay. So this is also gives a better efficiency when compared to the normal conditions. Okay. So here, and the last process here, we are using the reheating process. So we are wasting the exhaust gases temperature because exhaust gases also are very high temperatures. So that's why the main motor of the entire process are. So we are utilizing the entire energy developed by a fuel consumption. Okay. So that exhaust gases also we can utilize Okay, so here the output of gas turbine can be improved by the expanding the gases in two stages with a reheater between the two. So here also we can utilize a reheater concept. So here also we can utilize the two compressors. Okay, one compressor and the two turbines. Okay, in the previous case we are using the two compressors, high pressure compressor and the low pressure compressor. But in a reheating concept, we are using the two turbines. Okay, so that is the main difference. You can remember it. So here we have a two turbines. One is the high pressure turbine, and second one is the low pressure turbine. Okay, so the principle of the same. Here also we are taking the air from the atmosphere in a state one, initial state. Okay, so later we are doing the compression process. After the compression process, that we can supply to the combustion chamber. Okay, so at the combustion chamber we are supplying the fuel here. So here the combustion takes place. After that, high temperature and high pressure gases are released. So that we are sending on a high pressure turbine, because we are giving a compression process. So that's why we are using the high pressure turbines. Okay, so later it reduces some amount of pressure and temperature due to the expansion process. Okay, so after the expansion process also we can utilize the heat. So by using of a reheating technique, again we are doing the combustion process. Okay, here we are using the combustion process once again, but at the pan we have a very low pressure, so that's why we are using here for generating of a mechanical energy low pressure turbine. Okay, later we can connect to your alternator. Okay, again we are sending back to the exhaust gas to the atmosphere. Okay, so in this part we need to remember two things. In a intercooling process we are using the two compressors. One is the high pressure low pressure compressor first, and in the second stage we are using the high pressure compressor. So in between the two compressors we are using the intercooler. And in case of a reheating process, we are using the two turbines. One is the high pressure turbine and second one is the low pressure turbine. Okay, so all the things are similar here. Okay, the high pressure turbine drives the compressor and the low pressure turbine provides the principal power output. So what we can do with a two turbines here? So in the first thing, already we discussed that in a gas turbine power plant, most of the power is utilized by a compressor only. Okay, so that's why we need to generate or we need to utilize some amount of power to run the compressor. So in this case, two turbines are here using. One is the high pressure turbine and the low pressure turbine. So the first thing, the high pressure turbine is using to the running of a compressor. In the second case, the low pressure turbine also gives the mechanical energy. So that energy we can utilize for producing the electrical energy. So these are the concepts of a regenerative intercooling and the reheating concepts. Okay. So most of the cases we are focusing in this section, classification of a gas turbine. Classification of gas turbine, that is the GT. So classification here, two variations we are showing is open cycle and the closed cycle. Open cycle and the closed cycle. Okay, so what do you mean by open cycle? So in a open cycle, simply the air is intake from the atmosphere. In the same air after the exhaust process, we can remove it into the ambient conditions. So these are the exhaust gases. In a closed cycle, so we are considering a constant mass of air. So constant mass of air is fixed here. Mass of air is fixed. and they are rotating the same mass of air in air again and again, again and again. We are sending the same air into the cyclic process. Okay, so that is the main difference. Here the air is taken from the atmosphere and released into the atmosphere directly. But in case of a closed cycle, we are taking the air from the ambient and we are taking the constant mass of air. We are taking the constant mass of air and we are rotating the same air throughout the cycle completion process. Okay, so that's why this is known as the closed cycle. But in case of gas turbine power plants, okay, so in case of a gas turbine power plant, especially we are focusing on a open cycle gas turbine power plants. So for improving the open cycle gas turbine power plant, efficiency improvement for a open cycle gas turbine power plant, improving efficiencies by three methods. So what are the three methods we are discussing here? So we are discussing about three methods, especially the first one is the regenerating technique. And second one is the intercooling technique. Third one is the reheating process. Okay, so what is meant by a regenerating technique or regenerator? So in this regenerating technique, so we are using the exhaust temperature or exhaust gases for heat the compressed air. So what we are taking the compressed air, compressed air is heated by exhaust gases. Okay, compressed air is heated by exhaust gases. That technique is known as the regenerating method. What about the intercooling technique? In the intercooling method, we are using the two compressors. So what are the two compressors, sir? High pressure compressor and the low pressure compressor and high pressure compressor. Okay, so in between these two, we are using the intercooler. So it reduces the automatically work required for a compression process. In case of a reheating method, we are using a two turbines. One is the high pressure turbine and second one is the low pressure turbine. One is the high pressure turbine and second one is the low pressure turbine. So what happened with the two turbines? So by using of a high pressure turbine, it is using for the rotation of a compressor. For working of a compressor, we are utilizing the high pressure turbine work done, and for generating the electrical energy, we are using the low pressure turbine. Okay, so this is also, these are the very good techniques for improving the thermal efficiency of a open cycle gas turbine power plant. Okay, thank you.